everyone, I'm here today with a Stashbuster episode, number 10, I believe it is, first of 2017, so I hope you all had a fabulous holiday season, and your 2017 is going great so far. Mine is a bit hectic and crazy. I had a lot going on. I'm not going to bore everybody with the details, but if you hear any kind of dripping or anything, it's because the snow and ice is finally melting off the roof, and you can hear it dripping on the side of, like, right over here. Yeah, I've got a bunch to share with you, and I figure what I'll do is I'll show you what I'm working on first, then we'll go over what I'm planning on casting on next. I only have one thing, and it's actually not even casting on, it'll be crocheting. And I will show you what I finished at the end of 2016 that I haven't gotten around to making a video because I have been really sick and I'm still getting better, hence I have my lemon tea right here with fresh lemon in it to hopefully help me get over it. And I will show you some finished projects that I have for 2017 already. As I said, I've been feeling under the weather, so I've had some time to do that. So I guess let's get started, because I'm hoping to keep this on the shorter side. I don't want to make these way too long to bore everybody. let's see. The first thing in my Silver Shed USA wedge bag. This is really cute. You can see the little deer, and they're wearing little sweaters, and then there's sweaters on the trees too. I started doing a lace shawl that I just threw the pattern together. Just doing some regular knitting and some garter stitch knitting, which is kind of knitting and purling and doing some yarn over for a little bit of lace. It might be hard to see, I'm sorry for the lighting today, but with all the snow and being a little overcast outside, is kind of, it is what it is. I can't tell you the yarn I'm using, unfortunately. Sorry about that. Because they are actually mill ends. I don't even know if you can see that. But they're 400 grams to 454 grams, depending. This one is 14 ounces, 400 grams. And, let's see if I can show you the type of yarn. And I picked up a Joann's. Hopefully you can see how it's kind of rippled. It's thin and thick, and you can see tufts pulled out, and it's kind of like weaves, almost like, trying to think. Like the trim, that's kind of like the Chinese braid trim where it kind of snakes. So that's how that is, and I have not worked on it a whole lot, and I've kind of let it go by the wayside since I started because I have some other projects on the go that I really wanted to finish, but you're going to see those. But I'm going to show you here really, really quick. But this is actually how to be. This is going to be the top here. And this is super, super soft and squishy. I love it. It's going to be really warm. I really should get my butt in gear and finish it because it's so freaking cold here. But just so you guys can see the pattern. And I love this color. It's browns with like some hints of reddish brown, and it actually has some sparkle in it, which is really hard to pick up. But I'm doing that on my size 6, US 6 carbons, which I love these. I love the joins. They don't stick. They don't hurt my hands, and although they have metal tips, they are called carbons because I have a carbon shaft, and it actually stays a little warm and keeps a grip for you. So I really do like those. And that's one. I cast that one on actually right before Christmas, and I worked on it just a little bit. It's got a lot more rows in it, but I'm super excited. And then in my TARDIS bag, my Doctor Who, from Silver Shed USA, and I have my little pop figure, David Tennant, the 10th Doctor, my favorite one. I started Christmas already. I did pretty good this past year, 2016, with getting most of the projects and gifts done a few days before Christmas. Probably about, maybe about a week, and I didn't get around to posting them because I just don't have all the time to, like, I could film the videos in one day, and then I'm lucky if I can get one up or not, because sometimes the internet just goes so slow living up here, down here, wherever it is compared to you in Virginia. But I wanted to get a head start and try to get kind of squirrel away a few projects from now until then. So when I get closer to there, I will have projects that I could gift away that I don't have to stress myself out, because I tend to do that. I will kind of last minute. And it's not so much procrastinating, it's just I won't think about it until then. So figured if I start a little earlier, I might have a better chance of not having to stress so much. But this is my first project doing anything like this. And these are all using scraps that I have in my scrap bin. And I have like a big Tupperware, Rubbermaid bin right next to me. It's full of scraps. And that's part of my goal for this year. I'm going to show you goals at the end. So I have this medium time green, variegated blue, tan, and white. And you probably noticed these from some of the projects I've been posting on Instagram and also on here on YouTube. If you don't follow me on Instagram and you'd like to, you know, all my links will be down below in the description box. This is like a coffee color. And I have a almost a royal blue. And of course, white. So that is the color combination that I'm working with. And I know I didn't tell you what I'm doing yet, but I'm about to show you. This is knitting too, and I'm actually using a 16-inch cable needle that's a size 9 to make this. This is the first one I have ever made. So I am doing my best, and it's the first color work I have ever done. And by color work, I don't mean like doing a couple different threads and kind of alternating too much. I mean fair isle, like deep color work where it's stranded. I don't know if you can see all those floats and strands in there. So it makes it double thick, and it's super squishy. And I really love how it came out, and I'm pretty stoked with being able to have such nice floats and the inside looking so nice, because I really thought my tension was going to be crap. But here is the outside. You see I did a rolled knit cuff because I thought that was really cute. It would give a nice touch. And then there is white and green ribbing. And then it goes into a blue and white, like almost a Celtic wiring. And then this one is really hard to see, but it's that coffee color with that variegated blue, and the variegated blue actually makes little stars. This between here and here, right? Sorry, I should have done this earlier and had it marked out for you with stitch markers so you can actually see. But between there you can see it's kind of almost like a snowflake star, which I really like. And then the next in the one that I'm working on now is that thyme green with the same variegated blue and tan and white. And this is just like more of like you do three of the green and then three of the variegated, and it's just doing almost like staggered bricks, but it's not everywhere. It's just every so often, and then there's a break by solid colors, and that's going to be the whole way down, except, and then this is going to be a stocking, so the heel will be a contrast color, and so will the toe, and then the toe, after you do this for the main body, the green with the variegated, do it for the main body of the sock, or stocking, whichever you want to call it, then I will go into doing some more patterning. Maybe I'll reverse these and put that up to the toe so it's a repeat. But I really wanted to do two of these this year, I'm hoping. Now this kills my hands. I think it's because I'm so nervous with doing it that I just hold my tension and then I have to release it as I'm going. But I think as the further I go, because there's really not too much puckering, as you can see, which I'm really proud of. But I think the further I go and the more I work on it, it'll be easier. But I do want to at least get two of these done. I want to give one to my daughter and one to my son for Christmas for 2017. I'm hoping. If it doesn't get done, I'm not going to stress about it. But I'm super excited about this. Yeah, so that I cast on this year, the beginning of January. And that was my first, like, Fair Isle project ever, and I'm in love. It's not one of those things, because I'm usually a product knitter, someone who's just got a, or product crocheter, either way. I want the item at the end, so I want to get through it, and the quicker the better. But that, for the Fair Isle, I really enjoy it, and I think it's more for the process that I really like that. And I can finally understand what people mean by the process, processing and enjoying it. Now what, we'll move on to what I want to cast on this year. I was requested by my daughter to make another stuffy, I guess you want to call it, or a little crochet animal. This one may not be so little. I think he's gonna probably come out on the bigger size, maybe 12 to 13 inches. I'm hoping not too big. I do have everything I need to make it. I'll have to show you guys the yarn here. I have orange, and these are all that are Red Heart, the Super Saver. And this is actually the newer one, so these are much softer than the old ones. The old Red Heart were really itchy and rough, so this acrylic I really don't mind because it's a softer thing. Plus it's for a stuffed animal, and it's going to get squished, it's going to get abused, it'll probably be thrown in the washer a few times, so this acrylic holds up really good, and it's a good price. This is the pumpkin colorway, and I got a jumbo of the white, only because I use a lot of white for detailing, so I figured I could use it in other projects. And this is actually soft white, so we have orange, soft white, and I have a little bit of old school color match. Now this stuff, I don't mind working with, but it's definitely not as soft as the newer Red Heart. But it holds up very well for toys, for kids that are rough, and my kids were extremely rough when they were little, so I have yarn set aside just for animals, because they're constantly getting, you know, mauled and loved and everything. But those are my three colors, and then I got two big bags of fiberfill to stuff them with. But this is these colors right here. I'm hoping I can pull it off, as I'm gonna come up with a pattern, and I'm going to make her Hobbs from Calvin and Hobbes. Her birthday is in March, and I would really like to have it done for her then, so I really got to get my butt in gear with everything else I've got going on and start that, especially since I make my patterns as I go along. But I'm really excited about that. I love Calvin and Hobbes. I used to read it to the kids, you know, when they were younger too, and that's what got them actually into reading, because both of them, both my daughter and my son, really weren't big readers when they were little. Just like any other kid, they wanted to play more. But I think Calvin and Hobbes, and looking at all the colors and that their stuffed animal would come to life and play, you know, that really drew them in and then got them into more of the fantasy reading, which really now I lucked out. Both of my kids are avid readers, and they would take that pretty much over anything, so. Okay. Now, for my most recent cast on, I want to show you. This I actually started just a couple days ago, and actually 2 days ago. And it's my Grand Canyon socks, and I'm going to do a contrasting toe, heel, and cuff, I believe, on these. And I have the toe cast on in this one, because I like to work on them. I'm gonna blank here. Yeah, I can't think of it. Not simultaneously, not congruently, but and it's not two at a time because I worked the toe on this one, then I worked the, then I started a little bit of the Canyon, Grand Canyon colorway, and then after two rows of that, so I could tie my ends in, I went and did this toe, and then I put this away until I get all the way to the heel. When I get to the heel, I will go on and do cast on the Grand Canyon colorway here, and go up to the heel, and then I'll do the heel, and then work up the legs, and so on. And I love working them like that because the socks go so much quicker. And I don't know what pattern I want to do. If I want to do my regular vanilla sock with a ribbed leg, because the ribbing actually holds onto your legs. Because I noticed that a lot of the patterns, like, they're stretchy, but they don't cave back in on themselves enough and pull tightly enough to actually hold onto your leg. So if you're walking, you know, those socks are like fall down, slip into your shoe. I hate that. So I want to make sure that I have enough stretch, but enough that it pulls back in and holds on. And some of the lacy patterns don't really cut it for me. I'm just too afraid to wear them because they're going to slip in my boot, and I hate that. Especially in winter, and you get the taller boots on and it's really hard to get to them. Yeah, sorry about babbling. But you could do it with some of the lace patterns, just make a taller cuff, and I don't really, like, it's fine. I like to call tall cuffs if I'm using the same color, but I don't like the starkness of where if I've got the white toe, the white heel, and then you've got this short leg, but then you've got a cuff that's exactly the same size. I really don't like the look of that, because the cuff I could do in ribbing, that would be able to hold it and secure it to your leg. So I'm kind of picky, but you follow me, you'll see what pattern I choose for these. But this is the Grand Canyon colorway, and it is a like sandy-ish, like burnt umber and soft umber. There's like a teal blue and like a purpley blue, almost the violet colors in there, and they have some pops of the white in it as well. And I want to show you how it's working up so far. I'm going to turn it because I actually, when I knit like normal people across the front needle, but when I do socks, for some reason, I work the back needle, so the sock is made inside out. It's just easier for me to do the heel and keep my stitches tighter, and then doing it that way, working my socks inside out, which I know a lot of people frown on, and it kind of look at me weird. When you put your heel in and you pick up your stitches to go back around to go across the top of your foot, sometimes you'll get holes on the sides, and I don't want the holes. So when I work it inside out, I can actually hold the tension without pulling it too tight, so it's hard to get on your foot. It just keeps the tension just right, and I don't get the holes on the side. So, yeah, method to my madness sometimes. But there it is so far, and I really love the colorway and how it's working up. I have two more skeins of this yarn, and I think my daughter's already asked for a pair, and I was going to see about making my son a pair of them as well. But so far, that is my socks that I have cast on just recently, and that does it for all my works and projects. Works in progress. Don't mind me, I shouldn't be recording today. I want to show you my last finishes for 2016, my last projects. And I'm not sure if I showed this first one at all on my, on any videos that I have posted, or if I put it on my Instagram. I have so many pictures on my phone, I really gotta clean it off. But, so I can't always remember, but they got this new app that's called Later that lets you schedule your posts to Instagram, so it'll remind you to post them. So I might have to start doing that because, yeah, my mind ain't what it is, even with my planner. But this is the Panther Pink colorway from the new Soft Red Heart. And I did kind of like a beret pattern. And I know you can't really tell because I can't really put up like a beret on the styrofoam head. But I really do like how it's come out. And I just did, it's kind of like a zigzag, almost leaf-like pattern. it's really hard to see with this yarn on the camera, but in person you can really see it. And this is going into the gift bin, because I've been trying to find a hat that I really like, and I like how it looks on me. And I'm not too fond of this one, honestly, of what it looks like on me, but I love the hat itself, and I do love braids, but... So, that's one of my squirrel away gifts for this year. And I figured what I could do with the squirrel away gifts, too, is maybe every once in a while I'll do a giveaway. Right now I can't do it. I don't have the funds like a lot of us. You know, the year has strapped me so far from last year. Yeah, but I'm thinking one of those would make a really nice present for somebody. And sticking with the Bray style, because I really do like the Bray hats. This one is actually a lace leaf-like pattern. It kind of mimics, if you do crochet, it kind of is the version of the scales pattern, the kind of, I don't know if it's called crocodile scales or dragon scales. I know it's called both, but I think it's mostly called the crocodile scales. But this is actually a leaf-like pattern in knitting. And this is in the frosty green colorway. And I love the crown. I love the decrease on that. It is just gorgeous. It is super soft, like I said. It is so squishy, comfy, and warm. I love this pattern. I love the style. But as you can see, it really drowns me out and washes me out bad. So this one, of course, is not for me either. So into the gift bucket or giveaway bin. I do have a few people that really like this, too. I did post this on Instagram. I do. I really love how this came out. And the last project for 2016 that I haven't been able to share with anybody is actually my first pair of socks that I did contrasting heels, toes, and cuffs. I was kind of worried about this. Now, I have worn these. I have washed them, but so I know that they will hold up, but I was so scared that my joins wouldn't hold up, because I'm so used to joining yarns and crochet where I can guarantee that they're secured and are not coming out. With knitting and the way that you attach yarns, I was so scared that I would wear these and the heel would blow out or the toes would come out. But I have to say, I've worn these a few times already and there are no problems whatsoever. And I was hauling wood and all kinds of stuff and I had no, you know, being rough with them, I should say. And they were in boots and everything, and work boots with steel tips. And let me tell you, they held up and I love them. And I'm not quite sure of the colorway. But if you're interested, let me know. I do have the tag for it, because I do save them. And I actually made another pair exactly like this, and I put them away for my daughter. And what I wanted to do with them is, for her birthday with Hobbs, is I'm actually going to put these on his feet. Now, well, not these ones, but hers. And they're going to be baggy and hanging off, but I thought it would be really cute. So she gets her socks and her stuffy, so she can have it to take it with her when she leaves for her four-year college this year, which we're still waiting. She's still applying to a few places because she's still not quite sure where she wants to go, but love them. And now for this year's finished projects. Again, you're gonna not be surprised by the color because I have so much left over of it. Hopefully now I don't have a whole lot. I do have it written down somewhere how much I have. But if you're interested, let me know. I did buy like 8 skeins of it because I wasn't quite sure how much I would need for the sweater I made. So again, Panther Pink. And this is, you see the hat? It's a slouch head hat. So it's got a 4-inch brim that's in ribbed, so you can leave it down and have it be a super big hat so you could have your hair put up and it would just sit in the back. Or you could tuck your hair inside and let it hang in the back. You can fold the brim up. And if you put your hair in a clip, like I like to do, and most of it's up on your head, almost either French twist, bun style, it'll actually sit kind of up a little bit like this, but it won't mess up your hair, which I really like. And I really like these sock head hats, so I actually found one I like. So I have one to match my sweater now, and I super love it. The decrease on it, I didn't even show you guys. It's just a regular four square, like a square almost decrease, which, nope, not on this one. This is the snowflake, the starflake on the top, which this is really nice. I really like these ones too. The four squares are really nice, but I think I like them better on the tight-fitting hats. I just got confused. Sorry. And like I said, that's the first one of 2017. And I'm going to try to keep track of all the projects that I make through the year, so I can see how much I'm making and everything. And this one here is burgundy, has the same star-like pattern on the top. It's another sockhead slouch hat, which I love. It's the 4-inch brim again, and then just plain knitting. And this is in burgundy. And I really love how this one came out, too. I mean, it's super, super sweet. And like I said, you could fold the brim up as high as you want, and, you know, you can make it a tight-fitting hat. And this actually stretches and fits so many. It can grow with somebody. I mean, it could fit a really big head and down to probably a teen, from a teen to any size adult. And I love them. And then every year for Christmas Eve, I do a Christmas Eve cast on with Danny from Little Bob and Knits here on YouTube. And a lot of people jump in on it and use the hashtag, I think it's LBK Christmas Eve cast on, and cast on a pair of socks. And I've actually had these done since January 1st. That tells you how long it's been since I podcasted. I'm sorry. And since I've recorded. I have been so busy, and I'm going to try to keep up with it a little bit better. But I don't want to, I don't want to guarantee I'm going to do this weekly. I don't want to guarantee bi-weekly, because with my health and everything, I don't know if I'm going to be able to hold that end of the bargain up. But I'm going to post as regularly as I can. And some days I might not, sometimes I may not have as much to show you as I do kind of today. Or maybe I'll have a lot to show you. It depends on how much I could get done and how I'm feeling and what else we got going on. But this is the grapes colorway, and it's probably going to show up blue. I think that's actually showing up purple. I can hardly tell. Sorry, sitting back here, the glare on the viewfinder is rough. But I love these. I did the contrast toe, heel, and cuffs again. See what I was saying? I really love just the short cuff. But this is my normal ribbing pattern up the foot, which holds on. And I love how these came out. I love the colorway. And this is my first pair of socks for 2017, and I'm super, super happy. I would love to set the goal for myself to make one pair of socks every month for this year, so I end up with 12 pairs of socks for me. I'm going to try to do that. As you saw, I've got my grape socks done, and I have the Grand Canyon ones on the needles now. And provided everything stays okay, it's warm enough in my fingers and everything, and my joints don't start killing me, I'll have another pair done this month. So this way, if I have another month where I don't get around to it because I'm not feeling so great or whatever, I don't have to feel so bad about not getting close to making that. But my goal for this year is try not to stress myself out with not getting my goals met or to keep up with anybody else. I want to do it and enjoy it and not make it a chore. And I think that's why I stayed away from paper crafting. A lot of my followers are still, well, my friends on here, not really followers. I started doing all kinds of paper crafting because I loved it and I loved what you all were making, and I got so wrapped in it that it became a chore for me, and just like a, not so much a competition, but a competition with myself to try to get through those projects, to always have something to put out there, and it kind of destroyed my love for it. I do still use my papers and stuff like that for personal scrapbooking. I don't really share it because it's not really anything fancy. I'm just going back to the basic, easy, put some notes next to it so you know what it's about, so you have your story and client, you know, included in with your photographs. I think it's more of a journal-like process than it is scrapbooking anymore. And those are more personal memories, and I don't want to just put them all out there because I'm not sure everybody that I've got pictures of really wants to be included. But I'm still doing it. I just don't post it. I'm using my planners a lot, so I'm still doing that, and of course my fiber crafts, crocheting on occasion, knitting. I went through all my yarn, believe it or not, in the last, since January 1st. I've been going through all my bins. I pulled them all out in the living room. I dumped all my yarn out, separated it according to fiber content, and I weighed each and every bit of yarn I had so I could tally up. Yeah, you can't even see all the writing, but so I could tally up how much grams, meters, yards, whatever, but I think I settled on grams, but I wrote it all out so I could figure out how much I'm using in the year, so this way I'm not buying what I don't need. Like, if I need a color or a specific type of fiber for a certain project, that's okay, as long as I'm going to use it. But I don't want to go out there and buy things I already have. So I have everything listed in this tiny little notebook, which are fabulous. So I have the colorway and everything written, and it took up this much. So, probably about 20 pages of this little thing. And, including, I didn't do... The only thing I didn't do is I have one huge, huge bin of mercerized cotton, which I use for my tatting and for some of my, like, my crochet flowers and stuff like that that you guys seen in some of my older videos. That I have not tallied up. That's not included in that. Only because that's more time consuming, and it's really hard with those because the weight is so minuscule, because when you make those little things, they are so lace-like that they barely register. So unless it's a bigger project, it's going to be hard for me really to judge the weight in and out. But I did all my measures and everything, and I found that I have, through all the rest of the stuff that I use, I have 23,598 grams of yarn. Now, a lot of people might be, oh my god, that's a lot, but one skein of sock yarn, that little ball I showed you, is 50 grams. So when you get down to it, like my daughter says, it really isn't a lot. But I'm keeping track of each project that I finish, and I weigh the yarn before the project, I weigh the yarn after the project, and I weigh the project. So I can figure out exactly how much grams I'm using for each project. It makes it easier for me to see what I still have in my stash, so if I want to make another project, I know how much yarn is left in that, so I know if there's enough for me to make that other project, or if I needed to combine it with something to make it so it will actually finish a project for me, and I don't have to play yarn chicken and then be all upset because I can't finish a project because I don't have enough yarn. So the panther pink hat that I had showed you, let me see, this one, the sockhead hat, that took 97 grams of yarn, so almost two balls of the small sock yarn, which I think is fabulous because it's helping me get through my scraps, which is lovely because I'm going to try not to buy so much until I get so much out. I'd like to decrease some. I'm trying to go through my projects and all my supplies I've got, and if it's just not something I'm going to use, I think I'm going to gift most of it away, and some of it I might try to sell to help me out financially, but we'll see. And the burgundy sock head hat, although it's the same, this is why you measure. This was 91 grams. So it's a different weight of yarn. Even though they're both a worsted yarn, this one is actually lighter than the other one. So that's why I want to really measure and weigh everything. And then the grape socks, the grape colorway, the socks that I did, between that and the white aloe yarn, I weighed them both. So this way I know how much I have of each, and I have it individually on the skein of yarn. I have how much is left. But in all total, those took 56 grams of yarn. So that would have took a little over one of the 50 gram balls to make me a pair of socks. So that's why I usually buy two balls of the sock yarn, because it'll take me one and a little just to get the regular size socks that go to, like, crew socks. Now, if I wanted taller ones, like boot socks or anything like that, I would definitely need probably really close, probably 70 to 80 grams maybe, to get a real nice tall sock. So that's why I usually buy two. But one will do me because I like this length of sock, and I do like the toe, heels, and cuffs being different. And right now I only have the white, and that's going to be depleted soon, I think. Maybe I might get away with another pair, the one I'm working on, and maybe one other pair. So I'm going to have to look into making a purchase to get opposite color, because I really don't have any solid sock yarn with the, which is got nylon in it to be, you know, contrasting. But I think that's really good. So, I mean, that's 97, 91, and 56 grams already out on three projects, which I think is awesome. And then I also have that shawl. I didn't incorporate the skeins of yarn in that, so I'll have to add, you know, the 400 grams of that to my total, so that would be 23,998 grams that I actually have in stash. And then when I weigh the shawl out, when it's done in the skeiny yarn, that'll actually be another finished for 2017 as well. And the same with that stocking. Those projects have not been weighed and counted into these totals, but it's really not going to make it that much more. So, but I do have it all listed down, so anything else that's new that comes in, I can add the weight, the grams, so this way I know I'm moving things out, not just bringing them in. And that's kind of big for me, because I really do want to clean up my crafty space and start redoing it, and just keep the things that I want, that I don't feel pressured to work on, to get done, because the stress is just too much anymore. But, yeah. I think that's it. Sorry, just looking around me to see if there's anything that I'm forgetting here. Pretty much not. That's it. Yep. So, like I said, I'm going to try to be back not too long from now and show you some more of what I've got going on, and maybe some more progress on those, as long as I don't get taken up in something else, which could always happen, you never know. And yeah. But if you guys have any questions, just leave them below, or PM me. Be sure to check out my other social media sites to find me there. Everything's linked in the description box below. And thank you for joining me today, and I really appreciate it, and I hope to see you all soon. Have a fantastic rest of the week and weekend, if it's close to that when I actually get this to upload. And stay warm if you're in a cold area. I'll talk to y'all soon. Bye.